The Shape of the World, A Portrait of Frank Lloyd Wright, written by K.L. Going, illustrated by Lauren Stringer. One night, a mama rocked a baby in an old wooden chair. "Someday," she whispered, "you will build beautiful buildings." The baby smiled and cooed. He did not know about beautiful buildings. He hadn't seen soaring skyscrapers or elegant museums, but someday he would learn. When the baby grew into a boy, his mother gave him gifts: cubes, spheres, cones, pyramids, cylinders. The boy loved the smooth shapes. They felt soft against his fingers and heavy in his palm. It was fun to build them up and knock them down. He loved to stack them this way and that way and this. They could grow tall or wide, flat or round. Aha! The boy had learned a secret. Every shape was many shapes. When he was older, the boy spent each summer on his uncle's farm. He worked hard from sunrise to sunset, but sometimes, when no one was looking, the boy marveled at the great big world around him. He saw shapes everywhere he looked. He found an arch in the pathway of a frog, a cone inside the petals of a flower, a triangle in a spider's web, pyramid peaks of ant hills, and perfect hexagons in an empty piece of a honeycomb. He saw the shiny sphere of the sun and the glowing circle moon. Sometimes the boy hid in the tall grass, watching the weeds bend and sway, studying the shape of the bird's flight. He asked himself many questions. Did the sky have a shape? How many shapes were hidden in a tree? Raindrops made changing shapes, clear and cold. Lightning made jagged shapes, sharp and burnt. The river made smooth shapes, long and curved. The boy loved the shape of the world. He wanted to build buildings as amazing as the world around him. When the boy grew into a man, he became an architect. He worked hard from sunrise to sunset, but he never forgot the smooth weight of the blocks his mother had given to him when he was a boy. He remembered the hills and prairies surrounding his family's farm. When other architects chose walls, he chose windows. When others set their buildings apart, his were one with the world around them. He built a house like a honeycomb, a museum like a shell, and towers as tall and thick as trees. People from far and wide came to see his work. When they looked at his buildings, they imagined the rolling landscape of hills and felt the wide expanse of sky surround them. Like the boy, they too learned to love the shape of the world. One night, when the architect was an old man, he rocked back and forth in his mother's wooden chair. Her promise had come true. When he was a baby, he had not known about beautiful buildings. He hadn't seen soaring skyscrapers or elegant museums, but he had learned. Someday had come and gone. And he had changed the shape of the world.